If you chose reading number three, I'm seeing you as being sort of a timid person. If not in general, then within a specific sort of situation, but maybe kind of in general. Somebody who's more on the sensitive side, a little bit vulnerable in that kind of thing, not necessarily in contrast to your real personality, you know what I mean? Like, you're not, I don't see you as hiding your true self behind your fears necessarily, because it's a little bit of like who you are, not a fearful person necessarily, but like a just a more reserved person, right? Somebody who just is naturally a little bit more sensitive, which can come with some sense of being a little bit overwhelmed, right? And I see you wanting to like having a lot of frustrations with that, right? Wishing that you were more the type of person who could kind of speak your truth, which is a good thing, right? Speak your truth kind of no matter how it makes other people feel, without being so concerned about other people's reactions and that kind of thing, to be a little bit more expressive, especially vocally expressive, especially in your ideas and things like that. I'm seeing you coming through a place of this hypersensitivity, but it's almost a coming through the hypersensitivity to being hypersensitive, if that makes any sense. Like this sort of a hyper attentiveness to your nerves and things like that, and a little bit more of a well-rounded, balanced understanding of your own strength and of what it means to be strong, and what the positive implications of your kind of personality are, right? And it's not in lieu of getting kind of what you want and being able to speak your truth and speak for yourself and that kind of thing, because these are very positive things, but it's a little bit more of a step towards that, and a step towards having a little bit more reverence and respect for yourself, and therefore being able to speak out a little bit more. It's about being more in touch with your worthiness, I guess. Through, a little bit confusing, through, let me see, how do I verbalize this? Through kind of othering yourself a little bit, right? I think that sometimes it's easier to have compassion and have a little bit of bravery when it comes to speaking out on behalf of others, right, than it does to speak out on our behalf. And this is about getting more in touch with that. And it could be something or someone coming in that's gonna kind of like, I don't know why I'm getting like a mirror a little bit, but just sort of help you to kind of realize that. But I'm getting that it's more of a change in your attitude a little bit, is this kind of facilitating thing. It's about being a little bit more obligated towards yourself, right? Caring for yourself, as you would somebody else, and with a little bit more consideration for yourself, consideration for your needs especially. And a dedication to yourself. Getting a little bit more in touch with, you know, I'm seeing that you have these kind of needs, right, that go unfulfilled because you can't speak them, you can't verbalize them. They're like passive aggressively attacking you within yourself, if that makes any sense. Like they come up, you know what I mean, without your kind of permission and stuff like that, because you're not dealing with them, you're not addressing them. So this is about really a change in attitude, about learning and desiring to take a little bit of responsibility for yourself, as if you're you know, your own child or something like that, or you're a part of humanity, right, that deserves and requires things, requires things, and sometimes has to speak about those things so that other people can hear them, right? And it's about gaining that kind of, I don't know why I keep getting like an othering. It's like taking your most personal self, your most kind of needy self, and creating like a child out of it, something that you want to take care of, right? Something that you need to take care of, something that needs your care and needs your guidance and needs your kind of sometimes obligatory action, right? Things that you don't want to do, things that you're uncomfortable doing, but that little kind of child that you've sort of made and set over here, right, out of your needs, really needs you to do those things, whether you feel comfortable doing them or not. So in order to kind of bring about that change a little bit, they want you to be focused, as I said before, on really reminding yourself not of the things that you can't do, not of this person here that you're kind of like wishing to be, wishing to transform into, right? The things that you're kind of lacking, your weak areas, that kind of thing. They want you to be much more in touch, I guess maybe obvious, but much more in touch with your like the good sides of your bad sides, if that makes sense. Like I was saying, like your sensitivities and things like that, like really get to know those for their values and their benefits rather than the places that they kind of lack and where they where you're a little bit hard on yourself, right? Because you want to be able to kind of see yourself as that innocent, right, as that kind of worthy sort of inner child thing, right? To not like be beating up your sensitive part of yourself, right? That's the part of yourself that needs caring, that needs nurturing, that needs things, that doesn't need to just be, you know, brutalized into submission or whatever, because that's maybe how you kind of are coming to see yourself in this way in the first place, right? They want you to cut that out, and be much more caring and much more empathetic towards yourself. See yourself as a part of humanity, a part of society, a part of the world, a part of, you know, a part of all these things that are keeping going and keeping themselves alive and keeping other people alive and doing things in their life. They want you to kind of view yourself from the outside as one of those people. Not be so internal about things. Give yourself a little bit more of a break. Yes, I'm probably going over 10 minutes again, maybe not. Okay, that's it. I think that's it. Okay, if you chose reading number 4, the energy that I'm getting for you, your energy in this situation, is somebody who's very active, content, but feeling a little bit restless right now. You're happy, like I said. You've got a lot of things going on, I think. You're somebody who maybe tends to keep pretty busy, especially maybe like mentally busy, but hobby-wise, right? You might have a lot of interests, a lot of things going, and you're satisfied, you're happy, but there's something in your mind you have that you want to bring down to earth a little bit, right? A little bit out of this kind of like world of creativity and imagination, and a little bit more concrete, right? Whether it's one specific thing, it may be one specific project that you want to bring kind of out of your head and into the world, right? Or it could be in general, this an energy that's a little bit scattered. You know, it's productive, right? It's productive. It's good. It's a good presence in your life, but it lacks a little bit of structure, a little bit of structure, right? It lacks some maybe not direction, but some control on your part, right? You'd like to see a little bit more manifestation happening, even if it's, what I'm getting is that maybe this project is something that you're not really speaking about either. It might be something that's a little bit more internalized, but you're ready to kind of externalize it no matter what, right? No matter if it's kind of accepted, no matter if people know about it, really, right? You might be just ready to kind of do it without their support, whether or not, you know, and you want some, I feel like I'm just rambling now, but there's a very concrete feeling to this desire, right? It's something that can really help you, I guess, enrich this already kind of very, like, nice situation you have going for yourself, but that can help you kind of be even more productive with it, I guess, right? Even more realistic and grounded with it, rather than having it be a little bit, I'm definitely rambling now, but rather than having it be so kind of, you know, that artsy kind of deal where it's like very like creative, well-rounded, but not that directional. Okay, I'm gonna move on from there because I'm really yakking it up. I am seeing you gaining a lot more control, and it's through your being very like true to yourself and very in touch with yourself and not as concerned with other people's reactions or cares, really, right? It could be coming from some support coming from like within your family environment too. Definitely someone in your family that kind of sees you for who you are that may also be a very a very kind of original, I guess, person or very authentic, that's the word, very like kind of authentic energy that's really has your sort of best interest in mind, whether that's yourself or somebody else, and it is focused, right? It's very focused. It's almost like this nagging for this stability won't leave you alone, if that makes sense. Or somebody in your environment is kind of, in your kind of close environment is kind of coming at you like, hey, you're gonna do this. Hey, you said you're gonna do this. Like being a little bit kind of maybe pushy and obsessive, but that's really what's gonna kind of get you to this place where you have a little bit more control, or a lot more control actually, and could be. Monetarily beneficial for you also, if you're willing to kind of listen to that voice, and they want you to focus on being less, this is sort of similar to the last reading, but the focus on being less frustrated, right, less stressed out. I hope that I'm still recording. I guess I am. Okay, less frustrated, less stressed out, and concerned with perfection, right, with attaining this, the perfection that you kind of see in your mind immediately, and to be more focused on the gifts that you're receiving, and less defensive, right, too, less like feeling criticized, and more appreciative for the energy that this kind of nagging energy that's coming towards you, right? Whether it's somebody else putting forth the energy to help you kind of motivate yourself and these desires that you want to achieve, or just the thoughts that won't go away, you know what I mean? They want you to embrace those and kind of thank those and use them while you have them as resources. You know, don't be defensive, because you're the one who's gonna kind of suffer that, right? Ultimately, if you try to have control right now, you're not gonna have control later, I guess, if that makes any sense. They want you to be a little bit more, you know, active still, but in an open flowing kind of way, so that you can ultimately have a little bit more control, because right now, I guess there's just control. It's like you want more control, but you're, or more manifestation. Okay, as I was saying, you desire this kind of manifestation, but you're like stubbornly not doing it, right? Because maybe you're just the kind of person who's a little bit more easygoing, but they want you to be easygoing in the way that you're more, where am I going? More sponge-like, a little bit more open, right? A little bit more, or a little bit less easygoing on the same track that you're always on. And not having, you know, your walls up to like new things that may seem kind of perfect, kind of an imperfect, kind of annoying, stressing you out a little bit, maybe making you a little bit angry, maybe not the most, you know, pleasant experience in the world, but I think it's gonna help you ultimately get to the place you want to get to and be a little bit more, wow, I am really spacing out. I'm losing it on this. What the heck? Anyways, yeah, just get a little bit more control, be a little bit more, grounded, money-based, business savvy, that kind of thing, on top of it with your business and stuff like that. Okay, maybe that's why I was mumbling so much. Okay, anyways, that's it. I think that's it. Okay, if you chose reading number 5, I see you as being somebody who is a social person and very kind of extroverted, outgoing, kind of like maybe like a little bit of like a wild child. if that's you, let's see. Yeah, in a lively way, right? Definitely. But not necessarily always in the most kind of dedicated, directional way. It's a little bit off on its own tangent sometimes, right? But cohesive, very, very, within your environment, within your social sphere, that kind of thing, right? Your kind of social group. And I see you as wanting to take a little bit of a step away from that, or a step away from some of those influences, and in order to kind of be a little bit more authentically yourself, right? Have a little bit more, what's the word? Spontaneity, just creativity, just idealistic, these kind of like idealistic ideas, and you know your ideal self and your who, what makes you feel good, and who you really want to be, right? And who you really see yourself as, and kind of wanting to step away from some people or some things or some environments that are or maybe some ideas that are inhibiting that. That kind of free expression, right? And I do see you through this spread coming through that, coming out of this kind of, there's a wild element on either side of this, the leaving energy and the kind of energy that's coming in, right? But this one is much more, or this one's a little bit more based on things really coming in, right? Consuming a lot of things, accepting things, saying yes to everything kind of thing, like, ooh yeah, let's go do that, ooh yeah, let's go do that, and all these kind of, like, impulses and kind of, well, it's a hedonism card, so, like, a lot of input, right, more, and this still has this very, like, wild element, but it's more first of all, it's a beginning stage, right? It's doors opening and that kind of thing, something a little bit newer, less what you've experienced before. And it's very creative also, very imaginative, exploratory, that kind of thing. Strange for sure. Weird could be a little bit dark. Definitely kind of goes with this energy that I'm getting for you, right? Is this kind of like almost like a manic type in some ways. This is kind of being able to explore that weirdness, right? Yeah, I'm seeing that coming, and it's coming through exposure to certain elements, I guess. Through exposure to certain ideas and certain things that seem almost like, huh, like, is that like tailor-made like words for me that I'm just kind of like hearing coming down the street or something, getting that kind of thing, or like somebody says something to you in passing, or an exchange of ideas in a big way. Verbal communication. So it is still, it's not like a cut-off energy, right? It's still very interactive, that kind of thing, but it seems specific, right? Seems very specific to you, and something that's like, hey, I like that, like, hey, that's cool, right? If it seems a little weird, like, that's fine. If it seems a little bit dark, maybe, as long as like you feels like it fits you, like, right, like a little puzzle. Yeah, that's what you want to kind of look out for kind of coming into your consciousness and breezing by you and kind of, you know, bubbling around you and buzzing by your ear and that kind of thing. And even just speaking about ideas that you have and letting other people, you know, expand on that and kind of build on that, maybe bring in some things that you didn't really know existed or didn't know you were like into or whatever until now, you know. And to just that those things may be kind of like very present, right? They want you to embrace that intellectual mindset, embrace learning, embrace looking at things from a little bit less of like an emotional perspective, right? A little bit less of like this kind of like say yes, like floaty, dreamy, like lovey, like going towards everything kind of thing, and a little bit more discerning, right? Looking for those things that really do fit, not the things that just like maybe a little bit like fun or you're used to doing or somebody else wants you to do or sort of feeds your persona or something like that, right? You want to look at things that actually feel internally kind of congruent with where your mind is going, if that makes sense, with these kind of ideas that you're having and ideas that you're being exposed to. They want you to grab onto those and do a little bit of exploration and learning into some of those specific things, right? Take a couple, one or two like specific things that you come across and explore them a little bit. I hope that makes sense. I think that's it.